Most people think that bulging discs are caused by running, lifting, bending in specific ways, and all sorts of other explanations. But the truth is that bulging discs are caused by a completely different reason. And this reason is scientifically backed, it's been validated over and over again, but for some reason, almost nobody speaks about it. So in today's video, I'll show you what a bulging disc is, and I'll explain to you what the most common reason for it is. I'm going to do it using peanut butter and jelly, strawberry jelly, and some homemade buckwheat bread. So let's start. Look at this sandwich. We have two slices of bread, and in between we have the peanut butter and jelly. And this represents our vertebrae, the bones in our spine, and the discs in between them. So the function of the discs is actually as shock absorbers. They're supposed to absorb the shocks that go through the bones of our spine when we move. Those discs are actually meant to be flexible, and they're meant to absorb those shocks. When the bones are moving, when our body is moving, what happens is that they press from both sides on the disc, on our jelly. And as you can see here, there's a tiny bit that is bulging outside. Well, this resembles a bulging disc. For us to understand the real cause for most bulging discs, we have to go back a little bit in time. In the late 70s, 1979, two amazing medical devices were invented. One is the CT and the second is the MRI scanners. And those machines enabled us amazing things to look into the body and see the organs in much detail. It's an immense advance in medicine, which allowed us to diagnose better, treat better many, many, many conditions. But when it comes to bulging discs, it created a huge problem. The consequences are still evident until today. People came to doctors with back pain. The doctors sent them to a CT scan or an MRI scan, and then they got the results and they saw those bulging discs for the first time. The doctors made an immediate connection between the discs and the pain. But there was one big hole in the theory, one big problem. We didn't know by then what the baseline is, meaning we didn't know how common are bulging discs in people without back pain. It went on like this for 15 years, and then a first study came out that tested 100 people without back pain. They did MRI scans to all of those 100 people, and what they showed was amazing. 67% of them had at least one bulging disc in their spine, meaning many of them had way more. These are people without back pain that had bulging discs. More years passed, and the bigger study, a study that summarizes many high quality studies, was also performed. And now they took thousands of people without back pain and wanted to see how many of them had those changes in their spines, bulging discs, herniated discs, and other changes, other structural changes. The results were no short of amazing. What they found testing thousands of people without back pain was this. At the age of 20, 30% already had at least one bulging disc. At the age of 40, 50% had at least one bulging disc. And at the age of 60, 70% had bulging discs. And when we progress with age, we see more and more bulging discs. Let's now understand what those findings mean. What it actually means is that bulging discs are simply, in most cases, changes of a normal aging process. In most cases, they do no harm, they shouldn't cause any pain, and they shouldn't restrict any normal activity. Of course, it always requires a medical diagnosis, but again, in most cases, bulging discs are simply like the gray hairs on our head, or more wrinkles that we see the more we age. By the way, I'm Dr. Nir Brosh. I've treated thousands of patients, trained hundreds of doctors and psychologists, and organized international conferences on chronic pain healing. So if you like this content, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And if you're suffering from back pain, if you're suffering from chronic pain, and you want to understand more about the topic and how you can help yourself, watch this video here where I share my own personal healing of recovering from long-lasting pain.